Happy holidays to everyone who's taking in tonight's action on Hockey Night in Canada. First of four meetings between these two Pacific Division rivals. Off the draw, the Kings control. Here's Drew Doughty taking a look. Passes off. A one by the Kings score! Right off the bat, Quinton Byfield is on the score sheet. 1-0 LA.
And this is a set play. Everybody use it. Back to Doughty. Just watch the patience by Doughty. And Kempe's in front. There's a lot of traffic. I think Uyghur and Kempe are providing the screen, and Markstrom doesn't see that shot from Byfield. Sneaks that one through.
Now Ruzicka ahead for Dubé. Dubé finds Mangiapane. Mangiapane looking for some room. He played that smartly. Backlund over to Rasmus Anderson. Putting it on net, and the Flames score! Calgary answering back here quickly. And it's Rasmus Anderson who ties this one up at one apiece.
Because now in the offensive zone, Rasmus Anderson, this goes off the shin pad of Matt Roy and beats the goaltender Cam Talbot short side.
Roy to Moverara. That was blocked in front. Deneau, his pass blocked, but trying to jab it home there was Fiala.
Well, he's going to get it to the side of the net. And watch his puck to Fiala. Fiala's going to go right to the front, picking up that loose puck, and marks him strong along that post.
Unable to do so. So for Mangiapane playing on the fourth line, he's had some opportunities. What a chance for Dubé. Rasmus Anderson feeds Greer, who was knocked down to the ice. The Flames are in the zone. The Sharangovich pass in front. Cam Talbot shuts the door on Lindholm. And Lindholm was almost on the score sheet here, denied by Talbot. Power play a part of that as Kopitar looks to dig that puck out. It's Fiala, and a one-timer denied by Markstrom off the stick of...
There's a big scrum. The puck comes loose, and look how quickly he gets a puck out front to Kempe.
He's one of those Flames who wasn't able to complete the change as the puck comes over to Deneau. Philip Deneau. Time winding down as Tanev is ready to get back. And the Kings score! Right on cue for Pierre-Luc Dubois. There's his first goal since November 18th.
Okay, Spence is a good young player, and he's got a real keen eye for trying to generate offense from that right point position, especially on the power play. Man, this kid can move that puck around. He notices Dubois in the high slot, and Pierre-Luc redirects this behind Jacob Markstrom. Nothing Markstrom can do.
So it's a one-goal game with just over 4 minutes to go here. In the first period, Blake Coleman walks in. Huberdeau's shot. Talbot got just enough, and that one was wide. Connor Sherry to Godfrey, coming in with speed, driving to the net. Unable to get a shot away, though. Markstrom has 10-4-4 and 18 career starts against the LA Kings. Second period action here. Underway. Kaliev sending the puck in deep. Markstrom out to play it. All of a sudden, Byfield has it. And Markstrom shutting the door.
And both defensemen on that PK blocking shot. Uyghur first and then Rasmus Anderson.
There's been an extra emphasis on that. Here come the Flames shorthanded. Sharangovich to Coleman. What a beautiful shorthanded goal between Sharangovich and Coleman. And it looks like Cam Talbot is hurt on the play.
Coleman, in an attempt to go to the net and lift this over Talbot, he runs over the goaltender. He's trying to stop at the same time. You can see the collision. And just
Kempe reverses. Kopitar takes the pass. And now Doughty has it over to Kempe, and he puts it in front. Markstrom wasn't aware.
And the Flames are on the penalty kill, Hunter Ryan.
Yes, second in the NHL in terms of shorthanded goals is Blake Coleman, and as you mentioned, Scott, off to one of the best starts of his career as all of a sudden the puck is in the net, and it may have gone off of Yes, indeed. It's his fifth of the season, and the Kings, for the third time tonight, have the lead.
Take a look at this. It hits, I'm not sure, maybe it hits the stick of Uyghur in the, no, it's maybe Michael Backlund. It hits Backlund, goes right to the Ferriere to the right. Markstrom, it's a double deflection, in fact, and then it goes off the post and goes in behind Markstrom. That was just a weird one. Oh, right off the stick of Markstrom as well.
Connor Zeri takes a look, passes down low. Lindholm trying to force it home after twisting it.
Well, you can see why he plays with that enthusiasm.
Definitely, and now here come Kempe and Kopitar. Kopitar takes it, backhand feed. Kempe got his stick on it, accelerating. Moore enters the zone, a backhand pass. It comes in front, handled by Coleman and cleared by Coleman. Matt Roy, once again to Moore, quickly into the zone, driving to the net. He scores!
Kempe, good save, and then look at the speed of Moore and how he protects the puck here as well. And goes inside the triangle on Noah Hanifin. Oh man, that is a quick release. Oh, Talbot did not see that one.
Off the faceoff, Uyghur tried to put it to the net. Blocked. Here's an opportunity for Adrian Kempe with room. Movarara unable to get the puck out. Sharon Govich riding the line. A wrister wide on the near side, and that's going to do it for the first 40 minutes. As the Los Angeles Kings will head into the third period with a two-goal lead.
The Oilers, Talbot played 73 games and 142. He won't play that many this season, but the renewal of acquaintances in LA has worked for the Kings and Talbot. Arnerine
playing it forward. Zeri takes a bump from Roy. Godfrey controls, back to Zeri. Audrey now, backhand attempt, and Talbot was in the way on our broadcast.
Here's Kadri. He's going to be to the left of Talbot. You can see how Talbot uses his size. He's 6'4", and he does a nice job taking away high short side on Kadri.
Second best penalty kill in the National Hockey League. They've allowed just 12 on over 90 attempts. Here's Uyghur. Over to Ruzicka, right backstop, rebound, they score! And it's Blake Coleman who puts it home, and the Calgary Flames are now within one.
Earlier, it's not a hard shot, he's going for a rebound. So he's just going to throw this to the right pad. There's the shot, he barely puts anything on it, but it comes right up. And she said, basically, Kelly, you're terrible on Boxing Day.
Here's a steal, Fiala's in! Markstrom shuts the door. Moved it all the way up ahead. Fiala to Deneau. Moore with Deneau moving to the net. The tip. Markstrom was there. The right pad stop.
Seconds later, Markstrom again taking away the redirect and then
off the back of the net. Zeri got to it first. Now Godfrey playing it along the wall. Sharon Govich takes a look. Dishes. Godfrey makes a nice move to go in front, but Talbot read that all the way, and he has it. Corral that puck, and Flames forced to retreat. Uyghur walks back into the zone, though, and all of a sudden, some room. Huberto, Backlund, blockered away by Talbot. Matt Roy able to get the puck away from him, and Kaliev hoists it out. Here's an opportunity. Pierre LeDubois denied twice by Markstrom. Another shot. That one missed. Here's a chance for Mikey Anderson, tipped in front, and a marvelous stop from Jacob Markstrom. My goodness, he 67 seconds left in regulation. Godfrey and Kopitar. Kempe came up with the puck. He pushed it towards the Flame zone. A race for it! And Quinton Byfield with the insurance marker. His second of the night. It's 5-3 for the LA Kings. Another shot fired towards the net. That's going to do it. The Los Angeles Kings victorious here, snapping the Flames' three-game win streak.